Welcome to the Altium series on high-speed design. What we're going to talk about in this video is a question asked by quite a few designers. How do you determine whether or not a signal is high-speed? And so I'll try to answer that with some illustrations. What we're going to talk about here is not clock. We're going to talk about switching edges because that's the primary source of high-speed problems in logic circuits. When we go from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, those are the events that give rise to signal integrity problems. And so what we have to do to figure out whether or not a signal is high speed is compare the rise time to how long the path is that the signal is traveling down. Once we've done that, we will discover that one of two things can happen. Actually, both of these can happen. The first thing you'll see as you go up the speed curve is reflections, and that will be followed in dense boards by crosstalk. So we'll look at those two and how to tell when we have a trace that is long enough to be concerned about reflections or crosstalk. So let's first of all get used to the concept of time versus distance. This is a nanosecond in a printed circuit board. It's about 6 inches or 15 centimeters. That's how far a signal will travel on your board in 1 nanosecond. So what we're going to do is compare rise times to length of traces. And I have here on the bottom some equivalents. What we know is that when the trace gets longer than half of the rise time, we are going to start to see reflections. We can exploit those if we're series terminating, or we can be damaged by them if we have not taken into account the fact that we have a transmission line and an impedance and energy traveling on it. So this is a 6-inch nanosecond. At half of that length, when the line gets longer than 3 inches, it's time to think about impedance and controlling it and using a thing called a terminator. If we have a half nanosecond edge, then that's going to be 3 inches or 7.5 centimeters long. And at half of that, we'll have to start thinking about controlled impedance. And modern logic, most of it is 100 picoseconds. And so if we follow that same reasoning, 100 picoseconds is about 0.6 inches long or about a little bit less than a centimeter. And so we can see that pretty much all the structures in most printed circuit boards are long enough to qualify as high speed and needing controlled impedance and terminators. When the rise time is 100 picoseconds or less, that's when impedance reflections impedance cause a problem. The second thing you'll encounter is crosstalk. When does this become a problem? We're first of all going to control those impedance changes, those reflections, with terminators and by careful management of trace widths as we do routing. As we keep going up the speed curve, we'll start to see crosstalk, especially when you route very dense boards. And the signals running side by side in the same layer are the primary thing we worry about in printed circuit boards. Exactly when crosstalk is an issue is not a simple question to answer because it depends on a number of things. One of them is how long do the two traces run by side. Another is how close are they to each other. And a third is how much crosstalk can the circuit tolerate. And that set of questions gets answered with an SI tool by sitting down and doing some analysis of what you propose to do. Crosstalk hits its maximum about half the parallel length where we hit a problem with reflections. So about 1/4 of a rise time in length is where we're going to have to start thinking about crosstalk. And so how we're going to control that, this is all in the hands of whoever lays out the board. That's the person who has the control over how close two traces are side by side. That's the person who has control over adjacent layers, whether or not the traces run on top of the other. And so board designers can't figure out what the rules are, but they're in charge of making sure the rules get followed during layout. I hope this video helped you a little bit understand the notion of when things are high speed. If you did feel it had value, don't hesitate to pass it on to your colleagues. Along with that, if you have other topics that you think we should talk about, just let someone at Altium know and we'll see if we can't take care of that. Thanks again for watching.